What's up?
It is time for us to adopt a new company brand to encompass everything that we do. To reflect who we are and what we hope to build, I am proud to announce that starting today, our company is now Meta.
We're going to talk about a metaverse.
Meta.
I thought I was supposed to be the robot.
Meta.
This could be very positive for our society.
Meta. I hope that you will join us.
You're going to be able to do almost anything you can imagine. This isn't about spending more time on screens. It's about making the time that we already spend better. We're starting to see a lot of these technologies. Next, there are avatars. And that's how we're going to represent ourselves in the metaverse.
Alright, perfect.
I thought I was supposed to be the robot. You'll see their facial expressions. You'll get to decide when you want to be with other people, when you want to block someone from appearing in your space, or when you want to take a break and teleport to a private bubble.
Meta.
We're going to talk about a metaverse.
Meta.
I thought I was supposed to be the robot.
Meta.
This could be very positive for our society.
Meta. I hope that you will join us.
I want to share what we imagine is possible.
This is not the way that we are meant to use technology.
That's a little too realistic.
That's a glimpse of the kinds of experiences that you might have in the metaverse. You're going to really feel like you're there with other people. I also want to be upfront about the fact that there's a ton that we just don't know yet.
What?
So we're going to approach this with humility and openness.
Meta.
We're going to talk about a metaverse.
Meta.
I thought I was supposed to be the robot.
Meta.
This could be very positive for our society.
Meta. I hope that you will join us.
No walls.
Holy mackerel, this is unbelievable.
We may have brain surgeons in Edinburgh operating on patients in New Zealand.
You'll send emotions, feelings, memories.
Imagine a world where we are represented the way we want to be.
You know, in the future, it just feels like long distance won't be so distant.
There's a big frontier. Where do you want to go?
And we're just getting started.
Appreciate the past, utilize the present, but don't be afraid to create the future.
The
This is a call for an uprising. Welcome to today's show. One of the things I want to show you about the metaverse, the Mark, or I should just call it the beast reality world that they're creating, is going to be how is it going to get marketed to people so they want to go on, get on board, right? Because obviously we have 8 billion people in this world, and a lot of them are not dorks, like the ones who actually want to and currently live in Fortnite reality, you know, mainly extreme liberal type people who are anti-capitalism, anti-free speech, anti-guns, even though they walk around in their virtual world shooting everything 24/7. They're going to have to market this to get people on board. So one of the things, I'm going to show you a few things here, but one of the things that they're doing and they're planning on doing is starting pop-up stores or building actual physical stores. Of course, it's ironic, right? Because we live in a world where every store is just going out of business. I don't know if any of you have been to a strip mall or a mall. You see every store that used to be there going under. You see these videos online of like these dead mall series. And I get it, a lot of the malls are older malls, but even bigger malls are just lots of big stores and chains going out of business. But we'll have this store here. Why? Well, because they need to physically target people, ironically, to set them up to live in a virtual world. So, of course, they'll have these huge, I'm sure, testing areas where people can put on the headsets and they can go into the virtual world and they can have somebody there who's going to, what's your favorite thing? What did you always want to be? And they can transform them into it, and they're going to work them. And, of course, every time they log into Facebook, they're going to get worked with this avatar virtual reality as well. And then you have the crypto tie-in, which is going to be the currency of this metaverse and this, you know, beast system, which it's scary to me how many people get offended when I talk about crypto, like they're in love with crypto. They're like, well, cash is evil too. Well, no one's saying cash isn't evil. The simple fact is that the digital currency is the currency of the beast system. It's virtual one world currency. We all know that and all should know that. So don't take it personal when I talk about crypto. Again, if you made a lot of money investing in crypto and all this stuff, good for you. No one's not a shot at it. You can't take certain things personal when doing this stuff. There's things that I grew up liking that I know aren't good and, you know, and I should never have watched or liked or enjoyed. And I don't take it personal when people talk about, you know, things that I even might still enjoy not being, you know, legit or clear or true. So in other words, you know, the crypto fans and crypto supporters are so many, they think it's them stopping the feds. When in reality, the feds would never allow this to exist unless they wanted it to exist. So a few of the things I'm going to show you here. One, I'm going to show you a clip right now. This is of how they're going to start marketing this as a new life for people. A new life and a life where you could hang out with celebrities. Everybody's on an equal playing field. You know, you don't have to go to some exclusive Met Gala to run into a celebrity and pay $40,000 a head to sit at a table. You could just go into the virtual world and bump into Justin Bieber and have a beer with him in virtual reality. Sounds about as appealing as laying in a dumpster that's getting set on fire.
Wouldn't it be awesome if you could just knock out this monster in a semi-real, semi-virtual world? And just moments after, you could explore such impressive ancient places. Facebook promises that you will be able to do just that in 5 to 10 years, in its so-called metaverse. Whether this is just another ploy to get money off you, and if it's technically possible at all, is what we'll be explaining now. Dancing at a live concert virtually, or digitally meeting friends who live on the other side of the world at a party. And perhaps just casually meeting up with Justin Bieber and joining him for a drink. Wouldn't that be awesome? These are all Facebook's visions for a metaverse that is supposed to grow step by step. How serious Facebook takes this all can be seen by its recent change of name into Meta. It's all a bit Ready Player One, The Matrix, or Star Trek Holodeck. In the next 5 to 10 years, Mark Zuckerberg wants to establish this as part of the mainstream. It's a very ambitious goal. So far, virtual reality is mostly used by gamers and geeks, and only those that can afford it. You'll probably know some of the precursors to Metaverse. The online platform Second Life, where you can live a whole other life, to Pokemon Go, which was a huge hit a couple of years ago and which also received an augmented reality mode upgrade, to the PlayStation 4 VR game Dreams, which allows players to do anything from mini-games to creating virtual art. But Facebook slash Meta wants to go even further. So far, all there is are nice computer animations for advertising, but the company isn't starting from scratch. In 2014, it took over the VR goggles producer Oculus. And just recently, the augmented reality goggles Ray-Ban Stories were released. Meta is currently working on new AR goggles with the codename Project Nazare. There's already the virtual world Horizon. It consists of Horizon Home, a virtual living room that lets you invite online friends. It also includes Horizon Workrooms, a VR surrounding for business meetings.
So that's one of the ways, new life. That's going to be something you hear coined. A second life, a new life. A reality that's not depressing. It's your reality. Everything can be whatever you want it to be. You, you, you. Me, me, me. That's going to be one of the ways that they do this, is by pushing that. And again, remember, we live in a world now where they're constantly talking about depression, mental health, and these things. And obviously, the mental health thing ties into a lot of what they want to do with people like me and you, and getting us into prison cells, because they say that we're not mentally healthy because we believe in conspiracy. But also, they're creating a world that people just don't want to be a part of. That people are just miserable because they're destroying everything. And nobody can figure it out. They're just like, oh, I'm so tired. I'm so depressed. Well, you're having chemicals dumped on you. You're eating chemicals for breakfast. You're eating chemicals for lunch. You're having chemicals come through your air-conditioned vent because they're getting dumped on from the skies. I mean, yeah. And then you look around at the world and you're constantly hearing all this stuff. You got to wear your mask. Blah, 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 blah. Story after story, fear. Story after story, depression. So it'll be an easy way for them to market by talking about you can escape this reality that they're deliberately destroying. Remember, the Great Reset, the destruction of this reality to get people into that reality, bringing over what's on the other side, destroying this world. And of course, them thinking that they're going to be immortal and live forever in this fantasy land. And I mean, I don't understand how this could look appealing to anyone. I mean, it just looks like a nightmare to me. And you might say, well, you're not into gaming and any of that stuff. Who would want to? I mean, what do you have to convince your brain? How do you convince your brain that when you're in this virtual reality that it's real? You know, and they're going to make men attracted to other animes and women attracted to I mean, it's going to be an insane asylum. And it's getting worse by the day here. Well, we're not even at the tip of the iceberg yet, because when this starts getting pumped out, which it is now, it's like the article I showed you, they're preparing to have storefronts. The only purpose of the storefront isn't to sell the product, you know, physically to you, because they can do that online. It's to sell you on this new reality. And I've been talking about this, buying millions of dollars in virtual real estate. People are doing this. Buying clothing in a virtual world. It sounds insane to the normal, but apparently to these people, this is a big thing, and big business. Makes a lot of money. The NFTs and all that stuff. If you're not familiar, it makes a lot of money. Big brands like Nike, they're selling virtual clothing. Don't ask me, I mean, how this could be appealing at all. But I'm watching, I'm trying to catch up on some of this stuff because there's 8,000 things that I cover. And, you know, being in nerd land isn't really, you know, something I was expecting to happen this soon, this nerd reality, this virtual world, even though I've been talking about it for a while. But now catching up with, you know, what is the mindset of the youth out there? And they literally tell them it's like more important in this nerd reality to have cool clothes there than it is here in the real world.
Have a special occasion. They actually asked me to buy them Robux, which is a digital currency inside Roblox, right? And they use it to buy avatar skins. And, you know, the way they look in game to them is almost as important as the way they look in real life.
I mean, that's scary, right? To look cooler in the fake world. And this is the stuff that they're going to do. And by having storefronts all over the country, offering incentives for people to come in, to check it out, and then customizing virtual experiences for them, which is what Facebook/Meta is going to do. Customize virtual experiences. Well, where did you always want to be? Oh, I always wanted to live in the mountains in a log cabin, or I wanted to live on the beach in Maui. And then, boom, they put the glasses on you. They put you there. No, I always wanted to date, so-and-so, some model or whatever, even though it's probably a trans. And they put the person in there with you. I mean, this will be how they, and people will just be like, oh, my goodness. I thought it was like, you know, something else, and I could have this whole new life. I could be married in this world to a supermodel trans instead of being, you know, in this world with my real physical family. And trust me, marketing it that way and marketing it as a new life, these people are going to want it. So the metaverse is something that everybody should be keeping their eye on because, celebrities are endorsing the NFTs. I've already covered that. And they're endorsing crypto. And that should be a telltale sign for a lot of people out there who endorse crypto to understand that celebrities are not on your side. If they're endorsing it, they're engineering it. And them engineering it means this is what the elites want. That's the whole job of the celebrity, to engineer it and endorse it to get the masses on board with it, right? And again, I've talked about it over and over. Go to a store, you'll see a sign. Go to 5 stores today, I guarantee you you'll see one sign that says exact change only. We don't have cash, not accepting cash, because the distribution of cash is being cut off. So they're getting people prepped for this. And then in this reality, you will only be able to buy or sell if you're hooked up to this world. And you're going to be physically hooked up to it. This isn't going to be wearing the goggles, taking them off, going back and forth. You know, it's going to be physically attached to you. People are going to be physically connected. They talked about that at the Great Reset. I've been talking about it with the graphene, getting this inside of people's bodies, then having them connect to it, and then being able to buy or sell in this virtual world. You will have to be a part of this reality, or you will not be able to buy or sell or anything else. So this is where we're headed in this wonderful time to be alive in 2021. Oh, man. It's like the Lawnmower Man on acid and some of these other movies I've covered over the years. But this is what it is. And this is what we've got to keep, you got to keep plugging along. That's all you can do. You got to endure. We're all asked to endure. We must endure. And you got to be vigilant and aware of this stuff, because it's happening right in front of our faces. And some people want to deny it. Look, if it makes you feel better to deny it, go ahead. I don't like to live in fantasy land. I don't like to live a naive reality thinking, I'm not optimistic. And people, they're always like, gosh, you're so not optimistic. So everything's just the glass half empty with you, Call. And everyone I know, and I'm like, well, I'm not naive. I don't try to tell myself that something's going to be wonderful. I'd rather set myself up for the worst so I'm prepared. And, most of the time in my life, it isn't wonderful. So go figure, right? But, hey, that's life. This reality is not made for us, those who have faith, those who believe in the King of Kings. This is not our world. We are not in love with the things of this world. We don't, love this. You have to endure this and hopefully wake people up to what's happening. So I'll keep informing you on this stuff the more I see. When I see articles like this pop up that they're going to have physical stores, I feel it's important to let you know, because you have to see how they're going to start marketing this, right? The new life, no depression, whatever reality you want, physical stores so they can give you your physical experience, at least customize, I should say, experience, so that you can have your Fantasyland reality, and then they could keep marketing you with it so you want it, and you get on board with it. Because that's what they do. Repetition, beat it into your head, seduce you with their crap. And that's why, everybody's hooked up to the internet. That's why you can't go out without people on their cell phones. No one ever even looks at you in the eye anymore. It's a really ugly, scary world. But they tell you on the TV, love, 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 everything's great. And these zombies are like, yeah.
What's going on, everybody? So I got my alter ego finished. And his name is Blue. And for the mocap geeks out there, he's set up with the usual recipe of XNs for the body capture, Manus gloves for the hands, AR kit for the face. And it's all happening right here within the Unreal Engine. Yeah. But what's special about Blue is that I'm going to be inhabiting him every week because we are starting a new YouTube show called Xanadu. And if you love shows where a blue alien tries building a virtual empire from nothing, then you're gonna love Xanadu. This isn't a metaverse. It's like a little tiny meta bubble. Alexa, what the f- happened? I literally followed most of the directions.
I told you those plans were a waste of a Bitcoin.
So stay tuned. The metaverse is about to get a new inhabitant. Yeah.
Still alive, but I can't feel. I got stuff inside, but it's not real. They say I'm fine, but I feel sensitive. Nothing human left in me. Just a machine full of moving parts. I got emptiness where I used to have a heart.
I turn my collar to the cold and Circuits like freeways. I kept dreaming of a world I thought I'd never see. And then, one day...
You got in.
That's right, man. I got in. And the world was more beautiful than I ever dreamed. And also, more dangerous than I ever imagined. Hop in bed, nephew. Come on. Now, I met a brave warrior.
Tron!
Bum, 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 Tron!
He fights for the users.
He sure does. Oh, man, he showed me things that no one had ever imagined. There are these disc battles fought in spectacular arenas and cycles that raced on ribbons of light. So radical. And together...
You built the grid.
We built a new grid for programs and users. Now, I couldn't be in there all the time, so... I created a program in my own image that could think like you and me. And I called him Clue.
Codified likeness utility.
That's right. And Clue, Tron, and I, we built a system where all information was free and open.
This world is truly out of its mind. Just as you think you have a handle on what is going on, and you feel you have a solid grasp on what is being planned in this world, these people then introduce new agendas. The timing of my awareness and grasp on this subject is something that is not coincidental at all. A day before Facebook's major announcement, while I was engaging in research on another subject, I was introduced to this overall agenda. I would hear about the metaverse here and there and just ignore it. To me, it just sounded like another one of their distractions to get me off of my game. But as I began to look into this for myself, I realized just how wrong I actually was, and quite frankly, I was older than I thought myself to be. To be very honest, this whole agenda really aged me, because as I was learning it, I kept saying the same phrase, and when I started explaining it to my wife, she said the same thing as well. I don't get it. Honestly, I didn't actually get how this all was going to be attractive to people and why people would choose this. But I realized that the younger generation was being conditioned for this agenda since they were very young. And the truth is that my generation has been as well. After I realized how big this agenda was, I instantly started to dig in to gain understanding. And as I was reading and learning, I will be reminded of all the small influences that were shown to me over my lifespan of 40 years or so that have been conditioning me for this agenda. Now, I am in no way an expert on this agenda, but I do have a big enough grasp on it that I can communicate what it is all about from an alternative perspective than the hundreds to thousands of cheerleaders that are cheering on this new world that is being created right before us. This agenda must be understood for multiple reasons. For those of you watching that have young children or even raising young adults, if you care about them, it's imperative that you understand this agenda as well. The world is changing fast. In the past, in many of my videos, I have always stated that one of the biggest agendas in this world is about creating a new world order. But to my surprise, the agenda is not only about creating a new world order, but along with it, a completely new world altogether. It's time to understand this agenda. It's time to understand the metaverse. Let's begin. So this is one of those discussions that everyone needs to really pay attention to and learn. They are slowly planning on introducing us into a new digital world that they are creating. The stuff that looked like science fiction that they spoke about in movies is really a reality that they want us to be a part of. And like everything else that they do, they are not preparing the masses by proper notification and education, but they are not hiding it either. They have put the information out there for us. And like with everything else, it is up for us as individuals to do our own due diligence to understand and prepare. They introduced this whole thing under a backdrop of problems at Facebook with the whistleblower distraction and a whole attack on one of the most powerful tech companies in the world. They made the public believe that the announcement at Facebook was simply about them trying to save their brand from the bad engineered press they were receiving. Because if Facebook made this change without the backdrop of this whistleblower and being bad for children nonsense, as if these people really care, then more people would be asking questions. But what we have here is that one of the most powerful tech companies in the world that has 2.9 billion active users around the world, a company that knows more about each individual in the world than they ever should, is now changing their focus from social media to the metaverse. And the majority of the masses don't even question what is going on and what the metaverse is because of the distraction that was created for them a little beforehand. It was a perfect smokescreen. But for me, it's not something that can be ignored. And it also goes back into the overall picture and agenda I have been speaking on within this channel. So what is the metaverse? Let me cover that first.
The next platform and medium will be even more immersive, an embodied internet where you're in the experience, not just looking at it. And we call this the metaverse. And you're going to be able to do almost anything you can imagine. Get together with friends and family, work, learn, play, shop, create, as well as entirely new categories that don't really fit how we think about computers or phones today.
Well, maybe let me cover how I got here first. I was doing some research on NFTs because I heard how Tom Brady was making his football an NFT.
We got it back. So I got it back. Yeah. There was a lot of
Is the ball in Canton or have you made it into an NFT? Talk about what the ball is.
it's shortly an NFT. You can autograph.io. You go there to bid on it. There's a lot of great things, auction items, memorabilia.
I couldn't understand what was happening because from what I understood, Tom Brady was going to be keeping the football.
Get it back, but I don't actually keep too many things. So in that circumstance, I felt like that might be a good one to keep.
But through the NFT, he was going to sell it digitally. So someone anywhere else in the world could own the digital rights to it. That made no sense to me. I couldn't understand why someone would want to own something digitally they never would actually touch physically, but spend thousands to even millions of digital dollars for it. Again, I feel like I was being aged out. So I had to dig deeper. And from that digging, I stumbled into the metaverse. And right after I got a small foundation on it, then Mark Zuckerberg did his keynote and made the announcement about the name change and gave a massive amount of details along with it. I'll be using clips from the keynote to cover details he spoke on.
Rather than just focusing on this year's products like a normal keynote, we're going to talk about the future. So let's start by exploring what different kinds of metaverse experiences could feel like, starting with the most important experience of all, connecting with people. Imagine you put on your glasses or headset and you're instantly in your home space. It has parts of your physical home recreated virtually, it has things that are only possible virtually, and it has an incredibly inspiring view of whatever you find most beautiful.
Hey, are you coming?
Yeah, just gotta find something to wear. All right, perfect.
Okay, so again, what is the metaverse? Very simply, it's a new digital universe, a digital world. It's the next era of the internet, which is projected to deliver a digital environment that is similar to real life. It's a whole new world that people around the world will be plugged into. The metaverse will exist in parallel to reality, allowing people to work, open businesses, socialize, communicate, and interact with one another in a fully immersive system of virtual destinations. Right now, all of us look at the internet through our phones, computers, and other devices. What the metaverse will do is move us into the internet. It is actually likened to living in the internet. Have you ever seen the movie Tron? That's what it's about. What you may want to say is, yeah, this is just virtual reality. There's no way people can live in the internet like in the movie Tron. But you need to gain understanding. It's very deep. It's much deeper than just virtual reality. You see, virtual reality headsets and hardware like that are just tools that assist people in plugging in. But when you add in the other pieces into place, like blockchain technology, cryptocurrencies, artificial intelligence, 5G internet, remote work, gaming, and online social activities, all these pieces will meet at one singular point to create a virtual universe in the form of what we will call the metaverse. People will live in an artificial, augmented reality.
Artists going around Soho hiding AR pieces for people to find.
3D street art? That's cool.
Send that link over so we can all look at it. This is stunning.
Okay, that is something.
That's awesome. Wow.
I love the movement.
Wait, it's disappearing.
This is amazing.
Hold on. I'll tip the artist and they'll extend it.
Wow. Brilliant.
If you guys like it here, I have another room that you're going to love. Check out this forest room.
Huh, let's see it.
Koi fish that fly? That's new.
This is wild. Hey, one sec, Boz. It's Priscilla.
Hey, you have to see this. Beast is going crazy.
Oh, I love that guy. We've got to show that to the kids. Can you also send that to my dad?
I'll message him.
All right, see you at home. This place is great, Boz, but there's something I got to get back to. All right.
People will live inside the internet.
That's it, Mark. I'm moving to the metaverse.
All right.
They will be merging the physical world with the digital.
And you'll be able to take your items and project them into the physical world as holograms and augmented reality too. First, we're building tools that creators can use to place digital objects into the physical world and let people interact with them.
The grand vision of the metaverse is to provide a parallel digital universe connected to our physical world through multiple digital technologies. This parallel virtual environment and the bringing together of the online and offline worlds will allow the user to experience and communicate in the digital world through avatars, which will be the user's chosen persona. And it will feature many elements from physical reality, including buildings, work, and leisure locations, and other different landscapes. One big thing that is happening right now currently is that people are buying digital plots of land in the metaverse. They are buying digital real estate right now. I mean, it's absolutely crazy.
There is a building boom breaking out, but it's not happening in your backyard. It is happening in a fake world called the metaverse. The virtual real estate market is on fire right now, and our next guest says there is real money to be made in this fake land grab.
What's unique about the metaverse today is that virtual worlds are being designed specifically for adults, where they can live inside these virtual worlds and carry out their life.
Websites like Rentable are literally a leasing agency for virtual real estate. Like, all you really have to do is just browse and choose the property that's within your monthly budget. Make sure the length of the lease is what you need and the location is good. And also there's a security deposit, just like in the real world, where if you're late on paying the rent for the following month, then you lose that deposit. And then soon as you pay for your first month's rent, the land is yours to do whatever you want with, right?
The ultimate goal of the metaverse is to look and feel like physical reality, allowing your avatar to move around freely, interact with others, and access information just like in the real world. The metaverse aims to connect with reality by designing a large-scale virtual reality setting where anyone can have a persistent presence as an extension of their physical self or company. The metaverse could also be a merger of all realities, filled with artificial intelligent entities, making it possible for people and other beings to communicate and interact in shared environments. An example of this is like what they showed in that movie, Free Guy. There are so many different purposes that the metaverse will take care of. Let me sum this all up for you. The elite of this world, who control a majority of the world's wealth. You see, in 2019, the Oxfam report showed that the world's richest people own 50% of the world's wealth. In their report done in 2020, they showed that the world's richest 1% have more than twice as much wealth as 6.9 billion people. And the wealth gap has grown even more larger since the pandemic. These people have gained complete control over the world and its resources. They own the land, the real estate, the businesses, our social entertainment, pretty much our complete way of life. And being that they now have a complete handle on all these things, and also being that there is no way to bridge a union between the rich and the rich will stay rich and the poor will stay poor, they have created an alternate universe that allows the poor to live in a digital reality where they can escape the true reality of this world.
A prison for your mind.
A place where they can use their digital money or cryptocurrency tokens to buy and sell in a digital universe. This will make the world a lot smaller and easier to control. While the rich will stay rich and own all the actual physical assets, the real stuff, the poor will try to build something for themselves online in a new digital world. They literally have created the Matrix. For me, I just couldn't understand how people could actually accept something like this. But apparently, the youth have been conditioned for this for a long time, which made me go back and think on a situation I had one summer a decade ago with my now adult son. One summer, he asked if he can play this game called Roblox on his computer. When he showed me, it looked harmless compared to the games he could have been asking me to play, so I let him play. And day by day, I saw that he would stay on the computer longer and longer. He wouldn't go outside to play basketball even. He would just play this game. And at some point, I got tired of it and took the game away from him and told him I wasn't going to let him live in a virtual world. Because to me, that's what it looked like he was doing. And we canceled it. That was 8 to 10 years ago, I believe. But I remember it clear as day, and what I was protecting him from then has evolved into something even more prevalent and dangerous today.
Gaming is how a lot of people are going to step into the metaverse for the first time.
So the first thing I want to do is give a warning to all parents of children. These virtual reality games are not harmless, and though by taking a stand against them, you may be removing their world from them, you will be doing them ultimate good. These games have them living in a virtual alternate reality that is growing by the day and intends for their minds to be attached to a world not created by our Father in Heaven, our true creator. All the games from Roblox to Fortnite to Grand Theft Auto, I mean, which your children shouldn't be playing anyway, Rec Room, and anything like that are introducing and conditioning your child to live in an alternate reality. The metaverse aims to be a central hub for all of these games and more, and will allow them to teleport and go between games. They have been conditioned to care deeply about their avatars because this is what represents them online. They buy them clothing and make sure they look good. This is absolutely crazy, but absolutely true. This young generation actually cares more about how their avatars look online more than how they care about how they look physically in the real world. They have been conditioned to care more about the metaverse than our true physical world. Last year, a rapper named Travis Scott did a virtual concert on Fortnite where 27 million users attended. 27 million. For context, last year's NBA playoffs averaged 4.2 million viewers, and Game 6 of the finals brought in 12.5 million viewers. This concert doubled that. So you can see this is real influence, and it comes from all around the world. They attended a concert while in their homes, and possibly many of your living rooms or in their bedrooms in your homes. This is the metaverse, and they are already in it. I mean, they are even buying Gucci bags for the avatars. Gucci bags for online characters.
All right, now you got to put it on and we got to see how it looks.
Okay.
You got a real life Gucci bag in Roblox. You gotta walk the runway. Yo! Okay, I see you with the Gucci bag.
This is 1000% real. And many of the games are introducing it to them. Even a game like NBA 2K, which you would think is harmless because it's all about basketball, it allows a player of the game to create their own character. I mean, these children, and also a lot of adult men, they work hard to develop their avatars who have very realistic features. They then take these characters and let them move about in the cities, talking to other players, going to courts, playing pickup games. They have been trained to create online personas that they care for very much, and they collect virtual currency, which they call VC, which is exactly like digital cryptocurrency, except that it is game specific. And they care deeply about those coins and currency.
What I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be surprising my girlfriend with the $70,000, 70,000 Robux Gucci bag.
So if you think that this is far-fetched and couldn't be accepted, this has aged you too, because it already has been accepted. And the better they get with the technology, the more it will be accepted and adopted. This is what NFTs are for. People buying digital property to own in the metaverse. You can buy an NFT and hold it in your digital home, just like Zuckerberg shows here. When I started researching The Great Reset, I found a quote from Klaus Schwab, founder and executive chairman of the World Economic Forum. He has a quote that always bothered me, but I could never understand how they would make that to be true. The quote was, "You will own nothing and be happy." But I now see how they will make this to be true. Because in the physical realm, you won't own anything. But in the digital realm, you will have possession of many things. Even your own house on the lake that you will live in virtually. And though the physical world will be a complete disaster, you won't care because they have created an alternate reality for you to live in. You see, that's also what they are not telling everyone. Let me help you see that. Do you know what has been the biggest promotion of this metaverse? Yes, the pandemic. When they implemented the worldwide lockdown, they pushed everyone online, and the youth especially got tapped in. Even adults got locked into virtual features like Zoom. This was all conditioning the population for entrance into a new digital world. Chaos in the world has been a catalyst for the most craziest change that has happened in the world. It's order out of chaos. And the great reset that they are planning that will occur after the collapse of the United States dollar will usher in the next phase to their implementation and conditioning. The majority of the planet who will be dealing with massive poverty, unrest, destruction, and in many cases, death, they will all be looking for an escape route of the physical reality. And the metaverse will provide this for them, which is why we are beginning to see the rollout now. The metaverse opens a parallel world of opportunities for those less privileged by their immediate geography or economic circumstances. They will create a world where everything is much easier to govern and manage because all lives will be placed online, where everything is logged, monitored, tracked, and recorded. The plans are to be able to tie our physical identities to the metaverse in a singular way that allows identities to be known and not duplicated. All profile names will cross throughout all platforms. And if you violate the rules, you can easily be locked out. This is literally the Matrix in real life, people being plugged into a digital reality. There are so many agendas that coincide with this, it's hard to explain in all one video. This video needed to be made so that there was an alternative view on this subject away from the cheerleaders who are promoting this new virtual world. Parents need to be aware of this so they can help their children. But most importantly, everyone needs to understand what they are doing to this world we are in. They are moving the world out of our physical world that our father created and moving them into a digital world that Satan has created. There are many different movies that have been alluding to this type of world scenario. But to me, it all sounded like crazy science fiction until I now see it all come together. You can be whatever you want to be in their new world. You can look like what you desire. If you are a 45-year-old, 350-pound white male, in the metaverse, you could transform yourself into a 10-year-old black girl if that is how you desire to appear to the rest of the world. There are no rules in this metaverse that has anything to do with our Father in Heaven. But there, of course, will be rules of engagement. Very much how they do now with all the current rules on the web of what they say we can say or not say. Rules like that, but more global and further reaching. But this is it. All the people talking about unfounded conspiracy theories are now looking very ignorant. They are creating a whole new world right in front of our faces, literally telling us about it, though they are describing it as benevolent. But if you really think about it, every movie that they have made that has ever shown us about people living like this all show very big moral and ethical problems. We are already living during a time where they are removing Yah's influence away from this world. They have been conditioning the world to forget about him, his ways, and his purpose for us. People already live in a non-biblical reality. But on top of that, they are actually opening a doorway for the world to walk into that will put them into a new world that Satan has fully created and that he is the ultimate God of and is all-powerful and all-knowing and all-present. In the metaverse, Satan is the one who is omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent. He is literally creating a virtual world to replicate Yah's real power, and he is steering the world right into it, unknowingly but willingly. And all of you who care for Yah and his word, who are believers in the Bible, who believe in salvation only through Yeshua the Messiah, in English, Jesus Christ. If you are a true believer, this new world being created is in complete opposition to your belief. It is a complete attack against you, and they are hoping that as long as you live in ignorance, you will not be the wiser of what they are doing. They are hoping to have a mental stranglehold on our children that makes them view this alternate world as a good thing, but is bringing them right into Satanism, allowing them to live and do what they want. Living in another world that was not created by our Creator is one of the ultimate gestures that will show allegiance to Satan and his new world. Now, someone may say, show me a scripture where God says we shouldn't use virtual reality. Maybe there are scriptures that have alluded to it, but I don't know if at this time I have recognized it. But that doesn't even matter. Yah created the real earth. The first verse of the Bible, Genesis chapter 1, verse 1 says, in the beginning, Elohim created the heavens and the earth. We know that this world that we live in is his. He is the creator of it. All things were made through him, and without him, nothing was made that was made. John chapter 1, verse 3. This new virtual world is a man-made creation where everyone can take part in creation. It has nothing to do with Yah. And when they blend their digital world with the physical, they are completely creating a new satanic world that Satan has dominion over. This is always the scheme or plot. This is always the backdrop and plan amongst the wicked men of this world. They are creating a world in service to Lucifer. And if you are not walking in discernment, and you're living in a world that does not keep Yah and his word first, you can and will be sucked right into it. Sadly, our youth around the world have already been conditioned into it. And parents, it is your job to have a conversation with your children and bring them out of it. If they have been using most of their time engaging in a virtual world where they hang with their friends, they have been giving more of their life to Satan's world. To them, it may seem harmless and innocent. And to us parents, we have no idea what they are seeing and doing in there. I am not completely against video games, but I am against living in a virtual world, hanging out in a virtual world. This is a major satanic agenda that can fly by the multitude because it just looks like technological progress. As I have explained in numerous videos, science has been placed as a god of this world that is creating its own ways and pushing forth its own doctrines and mindsets, its own healing powers, its own take on gender, and what makes a man or a woman a woman. And now, science is creating a whole new virtual world, a new world. And if believers do not get strong in their faith, they will find themselves dragged right into it very subtly, but purposely. If you imagine 2 years ago that the world would be embracing remote work, everyone working from home, having meetings online, you are a very forward-thinking individual. Years ago, there was not many who foresaw that the world would be the way it is now. But one event happened, and look how much has changed. There is a major event on the way, and when it occurs, it will bring forth massive change, and the metaverse will play a big role within it. It will facilitate a new economy. It will provide people with a means to escape the real world that seems so horrible. It will allow the new world government to speak to everyone on Earth at the same time. It will help ease people into the new world currency facilitated through crypto, because everything will be brought online anyway, so they'll just be doing everything in the metaverse. It will be promoted as a major contributor to help with the problem of climate change. It will be a major glue that brings the new world order agenda together. This is not science fiction or something that is years off. It is here now and growing every day with a goal of full implementation. And only the creators and companies like Facebook, now known as Meta, know completely where this is all going. It is important that believers detach themselves from this digital world and do not go through the doors that this world is opening. And parents, please close the doors for your children who may have already walked through them. I'm reminded of what Paul says about the wrath of Yah in Romans chapter 1, verses 18 through 25. In it, it says, "For the wrath of Elohim is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who suppress the truth and unrighteousness, because what may be known of Elohim is manifest in them, for Elohim has shown it to them. For since the creation of the world, the invisible things of Yah are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and divinity, so that they are without excuse, because although they knew Elohim, they did not glorify him as Elohim, nor were thankful, but became futile in their thoughts, and their foolish hearts were darkened. Professing to be wise, they became fools, and changed the glory of the incorruptible Elohim into an image made like corruptible man, and birds, and four-footed animals, and creeping things. Therefore, Elohim also gave them up to uncleanness in the lust of their hearts, to dishonor their bodies among themselves, who exchanged the truth of Elohim for the lie, and worshipped and served the creature rather than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen." It is so important not to be a part of this group that these verses are referring to. If you keep reading, you see what they are given over to. And remember, these people are subject to the wrath of Yah. And even as they did not like to retain Elohim in their knowledge, Elohim gave them over to a debased mind to do those things which are not fitting, being filled with all unrighteousness, sexual immorality, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, strife, deceit, evil-mindedness. They are whisperers, backbiters, haters of Elohim, violent, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, undiscerning, untrustworthy, unloving, unforgiving, unmerciful, who, knowing the righteous judgment of Elohim, that those who practice such things are deserving of death, not only do the same, but also approve of those who practice them. Romans chapter 1, verses 28 through 32. So these people not only practice these things, but they approve of those who do this as well. And this is how much of the world lives today. I read this because this is how those that will be living in this virtual world will be looked at in the eyes of our Creator. This is another wake-up call for those in Messiah to bring all thoughts captive into the obedience of our Messiah. You need to use some discernment. We must obey and follow the word of Yah and turn away from this world and the direction that it's heading. If the world cared about you, they would be fully informing you and allowing you to make your own educated choice. Instead, it tells you it's up to you to figure it all out, while it slowly steers you and your children right into it. Like I showed, our children care more about how they appear in the virtual world than they do in the physical one that Father made. You must be smart and above all, put down all idols and commit to the will of our Father in heaven. Read His word and obey it. Choose His world over the world Satan has created. Your time is almost up. Make the right choice. Be blessed.